Hello dear students, so today we will learn how to draw the orthographic drawing. So in this, first of all you have to see, okay, so from where the observer is looking this figure. Okay, so here in this case observer is looking this figure from this side. Okay, so now initially whenever you start with orthographic drawing, so you have to see what is the length, width and height of the figure given. So please see what is the length. So the side from which observer is looking the figure, that is called as the length of the figure. So 20 plus 20 plus 20, so total length is 60. So I will write down here the length L is equals to 60. Okay, now see what is the height of the figure. So directly if you see, the height is given as 80 mm. Okay, 80 mm height is given. So I will write down H, height H as 80. Okay, and now you see what is the width of this figure. Okay, so what is the width of this figure? So width, always when you see the figure from the top, okay, whenever you see the figure from the top, okay, so then only you will get the width. So width here is how much? It is 70 mm. Width of the figure is 70, so I will write down 70. Okay, so whenever you start with the front view, so always remember, in front view always you will get the length and height first. Okay, so always remember, in the front view you will get the length and height. So I am writing FV for the front view. Okay, and in the top view you will always get the length and width of the figure. Okay, in top view you will never get the height. Okay, so now let us see, we are seeing the looking the figure from this side. So for the front view we will start with length and length and height of the figure. Okay, so 60 and 80. So I will first draw a rectangle of 60 by 80 mm. Okay, so with very light pencil you draw the box. So 60 by 80, and rectangle I am drawing. Okay, I have completed the rectangle. Okay, so I have completed the rectangle. After doing this, after drawing this box, always mark the center line first. So since it is 60, so half of 60 is how much? It is 30. So since this figure is symmetrical figure, so we always draw the center line first. Okay, so I will mark the center line for this figure. Okay. Okay, so I have marked the center line. Now after this, whenever you are looking this figure from this side, okay, so now in the front view you can see, in the front view of this figure you can see this part. Okay, initially this part you can see in the front view. Okay, so I will start the figure from this corner. So this corner is our, which corner? In this, the corner is this one. Okay, so what is the height here given? It is given as 20 mm. 20 mm height is given. So initially I will draw a 20 mm like this from this corner. Okay, and then we will complete it like this. Now this distance is how much? 20, and this height, it is given as 10 mm. Okay, this height is given as 10. So here we have completed the first stage of this figure. So first initial part we have done. Okay, this is 20, this is 20, this is 10 and this is 20. Okay, okay, so after this, now this part, okay, this part of the drawing, this part, this edge, whenever you see the front view, now imagine that this part has come on the back end side. Okay, so this edge will merge with this line. Okay, So after this corner will merge with this corner, and next figure will be this part. So now you can see this part of the figure. Okay, so this circle you can see in the front view. This part you can see in the front view. So now I am drawing this part of the figure. Okay, so after this, what is the height? After 80, this is 20 mm. So after 20, rest of the height is 60 mm. So I am from here. This height we have taken it as 20. Okay, so after completing this front view, this part, okay, now after this 20 mm, okay, now rest of the height is how much? So this is 20 mm is gone. So after this height is 60 mm. So from here we have drawn 60 mm, okay, then make it dark. Okay, so now this part of the figure you can see, so I have made it dark. Okay, so now in this, whenever you see the figure from this front side, so you can see this circle. So this circle is at a height of 30 mm from this edge. Okay, now where is this edge? This edge is at this point. So from here we will take an axis. Okay, draw the axis at 30 mm height. Okay, so I am marking the axis at 30 mm. Okay, so I have done the axis. Now I will draw the circle. So diameter is given 30, so radius will be 15. Okay, so for 15 mm I am drawing a circle. Okay, so I have drawn the circle of 15 mm. Okay, now this circle is also there, but this circle you cannot see in the front view. Okay, this circle will be hidden. This circle you can only see in the top view. So you don't draw this circle here. We will draw this circle later. So here initially we have completed the front view. Okay, now I will go for the top view. So for top view, first we will draw the axis line. Okay, after drawing the box, you take 10 mm distance and draw the x-axis first. Okay, I have taken this 10 mm distance from this side and take 10 mm distance from this side. Okay, so I have marked this 10 mm. Okay, then you draw, after drawing the box only, you draw the xy line. Okay, after drawing the xy line, okay, now just project the figure from the front view. From this you project, and from here you project the figure with the help of projection line. Okay, then again you take distance of 10 mm. Okay, and then you draw the box. Now for the top view, what you can see in the top view, the box, you know, this will be length is 60. Okay, length is 60 and width is 70. So already our length we have, that is 60. Okay, and now we want to draw the width. Width we want, that is 70. So I will mark 70 mm distance from here. Okay, so 70 mm ka box I am drawing. So 60 by 70 ka box we have to draw. Okay, yes, so we have completed the box. Now after this, whenever you see the figure, so okay, so we will start from this top corner, topmost corner. So this corner is our which corner in this figure? This corner is our this corner. Okay, so in this figure we will see, we can see that we have to draw this part. Okay, so in the top view now you can see, you can see this part of the box. Okay, so now I am drawing this 20 mm initially, and then we are completing the box. So initially from the top you can see this part. Okay, after drawing that, now first of all you extend the axis line from the top. Okay, so I am extending and projecting this axis line, the center line I am extending. Okay, I have projected the center line also. So now after projecting the center line, now you have to see that in this what is the distance from this part. So this it is given as 25 mm. Okay, so this part, this edge, okay, will coincide with this edge. Okay, so from the top when you see, you bring this figure here. Okay, so after this part you can see. So this part of the figure is visible to you. Yes or no? Correct? Okay, so this part you can see now from the top. So now from here I will first draw, okay, this. Okay, so we have completed the figure here. Now we have to see from here 25 mm distance. Okay, this distance center line is at 25 mm. So from this edge I have to take 25 mm. Okay, so I am marking this distance 25 mm, and here I will draw the x center line once again. Okay, so this is our center line which we have drawn. Okay, so I have completed the center line also. Now after this, from the top you can see the diameter as 20 mm. So 20 mm diameter means 10 mm radius we will take. So I am taking the radius as 10. Okay, and here I will draw the circle of radius 10 mm. Okay, so here I am drawing the circle of radius 10. Okay, so we have completed this. Okay, so now once you see this figure from the front side, okay, so this part, okay, this part was hidden in the front view. Now whenever you are seeing, looking at the figure from the top, so this circle you cannot see from the top view. Okay, this part of the circle is hidden. So now you know that here you have a circle, but whenever you are seeing, looking the figure from the top, you cannot see this circle. Correct? Okay, so now because of that, what we will do in this figure, we will project, okay, from here in the front view we have drawn that circle. So from here I am projecting it. Okay, so here I have projected the circle from the top. Okay, and here also I have projected the circle from the top. Okay, so here between this part, okay, you are having the circle there between only this part of the figure. So this part you cannot see the circle. Okay, so here this part is here. Okay, so here this part will be in hidden. Okay, here you are having that circle that we have projected from the top. So here I have represented that with the help of hidden line. Correct? Okay, so we have drawn the hidden line also. So we have completed this view. Okay, now in the top view you have this circle. Okay, so now this circle you project it in the front view. Okay, the circle which we have drawn here, this you cannot see in the front view. So that now what we are doing, this you can see in the top view. So now from the top view which we have drawn, we are projecting the circle here. Okay, so I am projecting the circle from here. Okay, so here you will have the hidden line. For this circle which we have projected, so here you are having the hidden line. Okay, now for the next part, what we will do, we will set the drafter at an angle of 45 degree. So set your drafter at 45 degree angle. Okay, and from here you draw a 45 degree line. Okay, after drawing this line, now just project the figure. So third view, that means we are going to look the figure from this side. So here in this third view you can see this L pattern, this L shape you can see. Rest you cannot see this circle also. This circle is also not visible, and this circle is also not visible. This part of the figure is not visible now. Only what you can see in the third view, only this part. Correct? This part you can see in the this side view. Now this is which side view? This is your left hand side view. So you are looking the figure from left side. So left hand side view you will always draw on the right hand side. Okay, and if you have the right hand side view, then you will draw it on the left hand side. So here which side view is given? Okay, left hand side view is given. So we will draw it on the right hand side. So now what we are doing, we are projecting the figure from here. We are projecting the figure from here. Okay, just project it, both the figures. So just we have projected the figure, okay, and from here also we have projected the figure. Okay, and from here, okay, from the front view, okay, we have projected the figure, and from here also we have projected the figure. Okay. So in the side view our box is actually ready. So side view, what we can see, length and we can see the, what we can see, this 70 by 80. So this box will be of length 70, okay, by 80 ka box we will draw. Now whenever, now in the side view it is very easy, just project the figure from here. Okay, for side view you have to just project from here. Okay, and just project the figure from here. Okay, okay, so our L shape is ready actually. Whatever we can see the L pattern, okay, then this is between these four corners. Okay, so I will join it, make it dark. Okay, so we have completed this. Now after this, just what you have to do, you have to just draw the center line from here, project it and draw the center line here. Okay, and here also you just project the center line. Okay, and here you are having the center line somewhere here, correct? Okay, so we have projected the center line. Now just whenever you see the figure from this side, you cannot see the circle. So I am just projecting the circle from here, and we are projecting the circle from here. Okay, and here also in the top view you project the circle from here and you project the circle from here. Okay, so here after projecting it we are getting the projections like this. So it is very easy to draw the side view. Okay, so after projecting it, now we know that for this circle, whenever you look at the figure, whenever you see the figure from this side, you cannot see this circle. So this circle will come in hidden, this circle will also come in hidden. You cannot see this circle whenever you are looking the figure from this side. Okay, so now just what we will do, we will draw the hidden line for this figure. Okay, and hidden line for this part. Okay, and here also we are drawing the hidden line. Okay, and here also we are drawing the hidden line. Okay, so after drawing the hidden line, now once you see this figure from this side, okay, here you have a corner. So here you are having a slot, throughout slot you have. So due to that, okay, where you are having the slot, so this, whenever you are looking the figure from this side, okay, you are having a corner here. So due to this corner, you are having a slot throughout. So now what I will do, I will just project this corner from here. Okay, so for that we are going to draw the hidden line, because that slot you cannot see, correct, from the side view. So this part will not come. Your circle is only till here. This part of the hidden line will not come, correct? Okay. And here also, whenever you are drawing the top view, okay, so this slot you have to draw. So this slot will come, you have to just project this slot from here in the top view, and here it will come throughout like this. Because you cannot see this slot from the top, but this slot is there, it is existing. So for this figure you have to just project this slot, okay. So we have completed the front view, top view and side view of this figure. So now only just one thing you have to do, you have to put minimum 8 dimensions in this, so your orthographic drawing is complete. So thank you for watching this video. I hope this video is helpful to you, okay. So kindly like it, share it and subscribe it. Thank you.